There are different schools of thought when it comes to operating system design. Juniper's Junos and Cisco's IOS, for example, take very different approaches. We're going to see the advantages to the Junos modular design. When it comes to operating systems, there are two main designs, monolithic and modular. The monolithic architecture is very simple. All processes, including memory management, file management, device management, and process management, are contained directly in the kernel. This can be used for very specific purposes, and it can be very fast too. Unfortunately, there are also downsides. The entire operating system uses a single memory space, which means that a fault in one component can take down the entire kernel. It's also difficult to port to different hardware, as the drives are part of the kernel too. I've put a link in the description if learning about this kind of thing interests you. A modular operating system is a bit different. Each process operates independently, separate from the kernel, in its own protected memory space. If there's a fault in one process, it will not damage another. Drivers are also independent, which means that the operating system can be more easily ported to other hardware. Overall, this is a more modern, sophisticated design, which improves stability and uptime. For comparison reasons, let me point out that Cisco's traditional iOS is a monolithic operating system. iOS has been around a long time, so monolithic is pretty normal considering its age. Cisco improved on this with iOS XE, which is used in their modern routers and switches. It has Linux as the base operating system, and iOS runs as a monolithic application in a container. There's a link in the description which explains Cisco's operating systems as cows, of all things. It's actually a really good read. I recommend having a look. High-end Cisco routers run iOS XR, which, like Junos, is modular. Everything runs in its own protected memory space. This was, in fact, one of Juniper's primary design goals when they created Junos: separation of modules for stability. One of the advantages of this is that we can restart certain processes without restarting the entire device. While we're talking about processes, let's look at the common ones. You can practice with these in the associated lab. First, we have the chassis process, called chassis D. This runs shortly after boot up and is responsible for bringing the line cards online, as well as interfaces and other hardware components. Chassis D runs on the RE as well as on the PFE. You'll notice that most processes end with a D, which is short for daemon, which is the traditional Unix name for a process or service. Next, we have the device control process, DCD, which manages interfaces. This includes encapsulation, timers, VLANs, IP addresses, and so on. If you ever need to troubleshoot this process, run show log DCD. The management daemon, MGD, is used for management traffic. This includes incoming SSH and telnet requests. This also handles commands we send to the device and device configuration. RPD, the routing protocol daemon, manages all routing protocols. This includes OSPF, BGP, ISIS, and RIP. RPD's job includes performing calculations like finding the shortest path through a network and adding routes to the routing table. This process is multi-threaded and uses scheduling, so it doesn't devote all its time to a single task. This is important as it can't be allowed to get too busy working on one thing and then miss some routing updates. Finally, SNMPD manages SNMP requests and responses, as well as SNMP traps. There are plenty more processes. These are just some of the common ones you might come across from time to time. In fact, let's take a look at them now. With this command, we can see the name of the process, the percentage of the CPU that it's using, as well as some other details. The restart command lets us restart these processes if we need to. In this video, you can probably see how an underlying Linux or FreeBSD operating system affects the philosophy that Juniper has towards their devices. So we've got a good idea around Juniper's philosophy on hardware and software architecture. The next video changes it up a bit and looks at the structure of firewall filters, components that are used for many functions in Junos. Click the video here to get started.